The Douglas DC-3 was one of the most successful airliners in history because the aircraft's efficiency, speed, and safety popularized air travel. We're lowering disassembly and moving the DC-3 as part of a larger project that is revitalizing the National Air and Space Museum and transforming the galleries within it. The DC-3 is one of many aircraft and spacecraft that require these kind of procedures to get out of its existing location and to the Udvar-Hazy Center. The DC-3 is one of the largest, if not the largest thing we have on display. The first step is lowering it down to the ground so it can be disassembled. When it's actually being lowered, it looks very easy and very simple, but there's a lot of pre-work that goes into making sure you have all your rigging equipment in the exact right place so that the airframe can take the stresses from being put on those rigging points. The DC-3 is close to 17,000 pounds, so that's a lot of weight to make sure you're managing. Once the DC-3 is lowered to the ground, we have to take the wings off of it. Something like the DC-3 is 90 feet wide, so that's not going to go down any highway. We have to arrange for a crane that can only be set up in the middle of the night because something of the size, we're only allowed to move in the middle of the night. Once it's on the truck and it's wrapped, then we strap it all down and then we drive it out to the Udvar-Hazy Center, and there is a second crane set up and waiting at that end to lift it off of the truck and put it down on the ground. Every museum has a unique collection, and each collection has its own challenges or facets that makes it different. One of the things that makes us fairly unique in the US and the world is just the size of our collection of very large artifacts. You have to get specialized equipment, specially trained people. Everything about the way you move it is very different than how you move most museum artifacts. We couldn't have done this without pretty much everyone who works at the Air and Space Museum.